All of you, welcome back to our course Big Data Analytics and Business Intelligence. So our today's topic of video is data integration approaches. So in the last video we discussed about the various challenges that we face during the process of data integration. So we know that what is data integration? Data integration is the process of gathering or a process of extracting the data from various sources and storing it in a centralized source. This is what a process of data integration. As we know that for any particular business to grow, it requires a data, and that data can be extracted by using a BI. Means we are making use of a business intelligence to improve the growth to improve the sale of a particular company. So for that purpose we are using BI, and in order to generate a good quality of a knowledge by using BI, you required a good quality of a data, and that good quality of a data can be extracted from various sources by making use of data integration. So in this video we are going to discuss about what are the different approaches that can be used for data integration, and that approaches is going to vary from business to business. It's totally depend upon your need. What is your need? So in this video we are also going to discuss in what scenario which data integration approach is useful. So let's discuss the data integration approaches. So there are basically 5 data integration approaches are there. First one is a manual data integration approach, middleware data integration approach, uniform data integration approach, common data storage approach, application based integration approach. So these are the 5 types of approaches are there which can be used for data integration. So we have to discuss all these approaches one by one. So very first approach that we are going to discuss is a manual data integration. So in case of a manual data integration, user manually collects the necessary data from various sources. As its name suggests, manual means what? Manually you have to do each and everything in data integration. Means manually you have to extract the data from n number of sources. First of all, you need to identify what are the sources from where you need to just extract the data, and all these steps you have to perform it manually. So this is what a manual data integration. If we talk about the pros and cons of a manual data integration, then we can say that it is easier, somehow easier as compared to other techniques for manual data integration. You have own control. Again, we can say that you have own control in case of a manual data integration, but it's a time consuming process. One of the causes is it's a time consuming process. Then there is again in this case more possibility of error. Okay, there is more possibility of getting error is the another problem with the manual data integration. So the next technique of a data integration is a middleware data integration. So in case of middleware data integration, we are going to use of a middleware application. So what it will do? It will act as a mediator. Okay, it acts as a mediator, helping to normalize the data and bring it into the master data pool. In middleware data integration, we are using a particular middleware between the source and your storage where you are going to store the data. In between this, there is one middleware which performs the task of extracting the data from the sources and store it in your storage. For example, you are storing your data in the data warehouse. So that is what a middleware data integration. Here we are going to use middleware application. Then the next approach is application based integration. This is what a customized approach. As per the business need, you can design your own application to locate, retrieve, clean and integrate the data from the disparate sources. This is what a mostly used approach is, a application based integration, where customizedly you will design your own data integration approach which help us to locate, then retrieve, locate, retrieve and then clean the data as per your requirement and bring it in a particular form that you want. So this is mostly used approach for data integration is application based integration. Next approach for data integration is uniform access integration. So in case of a uniform access integration, what is the main point to note, what is a major point or we can say feature that you have to note is that it defines a set of view to provide and access the unified view. That is what an important thing. And in this case, we leave the data in original source. Okay, that means in this case we are not making the copy of the data. That data remains as it is in the case of data source. So in that case, it will create a view. So you already aware about the concept of the view. View gives a highest level of abstract. View is the highest level of abstraction. Virtually, you can access the data. Means complete data is not accessible. Particular part of a data is accessible. Okay, so in uniform access integration, it defines a set of view and it keeps the data it in a original source. Okay, it leaves it in its original source. This is what a uniform access integration. Then similar to that uniform access integration, there is another technique to data integration approach, that is a common storage integration, where you retrieve and uniformly display the data. But the difference is that here you will make a copy of data and store it in a data warehouse. Data warehouse is a centralized repository where you are going to store your data. But in this case, you are going to make a copy of a data, which is not the case in case of uniform access integration. In uniform access integration, you are not making the copy of data, but you leave the data in its original. You will leave the data in original source itself. So this is what the difference between uniform access integration and common storage integration. So these are the five data integration approaches are there, which will be adopted by a particular organization as per their need. So now next we are going to discuss about when to use, in what scenario particular approach is useful. Okay, we need to discuss in particular in which particular scenario which approach is useful, that we are going to discuss, because here we discuss total five approaches are there: manual data integration, middleware data integration, application based data integration, uniform data integration, and the common storage integration. So in that case, we should know what in what scenario which integration technique can be used. So this is a small table which tells you more about the situation. So manual data integration is useful for a basic analysis between a small amount of data sources, means when a number of data sources are less and you need to perform basic analysis, then you should go for manual data integration. But it's a time consuming process. Though it's a simple process, you have total control over this data integration process, but you can use it for basic data analysis, and it is applicable for small amount of data sources. Okay, it is useful for small amount of data sources. Then next one is a middleware data integration. So in middleware data integration, automate and translate communication between legacy and modernized system. So in the modernized system, you are going to make use of a middleware data integration. Then next approach is a application based integration. So it helps to translate communication between system and allow for more complicated data analysis. Okay, when you need to perform complicated data analysis, then at that time application based integration is useful. Then next one is uniform access integration. It helps to translate the communication between system and present the data uniformly to allow for complicated data analysis. Again, uniform access integration is useful for complicated data analysis. And finally, the common storage integration. So present the data uniformly and create a store copy. Just we have seen that when you are making a copy of a data and storing it in your data warehouse, so this is what a common storage integration, and it is used when most sophisticated data analysis task is there. So at that time you should go for common storage integration. So this is what a table which gives idea in what situation which data integration technique you should use. So I hope you understand all these techniques or approaches used for data integration, manual data integration, middleware data integration, application data integration, uniform integration and common storage integration. Thank you.